The extra security measures were revealed by Bashir Hanji, the Uganda Wildlife Authority spokesperson, after a 2 days visit to Queen Elizabeth National Park. Currently, the tourism activities have smoothly continued since a number of security strategies were enhanced after the 17th October suspected ADF rebel attack on a tourist vehicle that left 3 people dead. According to Hanji, the drone technology will help security to intercept, arrest, and prosecute wronged elements once proven guilty.
Will come when we have more than enough drones, and I can assure you, people who think they can enter the parks and properties and do all sorts of illegal activities, their days are not going to be good.
Although few drones have been available due to financial constraints, he promises that more will be purchased because of their efficiency and effectiveness.
We don't have many, but we intend to have as many as possible, and every year we'll be adding on the numbers. We cannot afford to have all the drones that we have in one go because of budgetary constraints.
He further confirmed that tourists have continued to visit the park regardless of the unfortunate incident that claimed the lives of 3 people. He reiterated government's commitment to ensure the safety of tourists and the entire country.
From the time when this incident occurred, that is on 17th, to yesterday, we received 957 tourists, and of these, 638 are foreign non-residents. And I really want to appreciate the effort everybody is putting on. The tour operators have played a crucial role in continuing to bring the tourists here. So I just want to assure you, security is guaranteed and we should continue with our tourism.
Sila Saxa, a tourist from the Netherlands, is confident that the UPDF soldiers are in a better position to safeguard the park.
Really enjoyed our time. In general, our experience and my experience is really a good one. I can say that I feel safe. We stopped, or we were a little cautious when, or as soon as we saw people walking around in the park, especially our guide, he's paying very much attention, and yeah, we continued as soon as we saw that the Ugandan army, and yeah, we see the Ugandan army all over the park, which yeah, actually really makes us feel safe. We really can enjoy our time here.
Leaders have assured the public on the heightened security, and they warned on the misuse of social media platforms.
Everything is okay in the national park. So I'm appealing to anybody who will wish to come to Kasese as a tourist, please, you are most welcome. Everything is okay.
In our national park, security has done its work. Visitors, even if you go there at this time, visitors are there. We have received many visitors, even this morning they were there. So there is nothing which can intimidate our tourists to come to our Queen Elizabeth National Park. We are in charge, and then there is coordination between our districts surrounding Queen Elizabeth National Park.
Queen Elizabeth National Park bears a number of unique features. It is famous for the tree climbing lands and beautiful landscape. The park is also known for its abundant wildlife, with over 95 mammal species, including African elephants, giant forest hog, chimpanzees, leopards, spotted hyenas, among others. It is also a top bird watching site. Queen Elizabeth National Park traces its boundaries in 4 districts of Western Uganda, including Kasese, Rubirizi, Rukunjiri, and Kamwenje. Report compiled by Samuel Amanyire for the news.